Hi everyone, and welcome to the latest edition of Who Is. And you're probably wondering, why am I talking and why isn't Devin talking? Well, today we're doing a little switch. I'm actually going to interview Devin, because if he interviewed himself, that would be a really awkward conversation. So a lot of you probably already know Devin Knight. He's our training director here at Pragmatic Works. So I want to know, Devin, what's going on in training right now? What can we expect this year from training?
Yeah, sure. We're doing a lot of big changes with training, mainly around how we present training. So we're going through some different avenues of delivering training. You know, we do on-site training where we can actually come on-site with customers. We do virtual training where we have a live instructor that teaches you through like a GoToMeeting environment. We also have workshops where we go to Microsoft offices and teach large groups. Those are kind of one-day seminars that we do. And then we have boot camps as well. Those are week-long, more intensive trainings that we do. But we're starting something new. We actually sort of started the end of last year and more into this year, where we're going more in the streaming or on-demand platform, where that way you can watch training when you need it. You don't have to wait for us to schedule an event. You don't have to wait for us to come to your office. Much more economical. And there's a lot of ways that you can purchase all of our training at once rather than having to go piecemeal and buy each individual training. So that's our big push going into this year, is on the on-demand platform. We're going to have a lot of great new courses coming that way. I won't say which ones, because by the time this video comes out, maybe there'll be new ones. But a lot of great courses. We're working on multiple ones a month, and I think you'll see those as they come through the on-demand platform.
On-demand seems like a really hot thing right now. You know, everybody thinks of like Netflix and things like that. What about for people who might be interested in on-demand, but they're like, you know what, I really need that kind of one-on-one interaction, or I might need some additional help. What do you say to someone that asked that question?
Yeah, that's a great question, because that's really what sets us apart from other platforms that do this. There's a lot of platforms that do streaming training or on-demand training, and that's really what sets us apart, is because not only do we have a training department like we do, but we also have a consulting services arm of our company. And so with our on-demand platform, what we provide is something called virtual mentoring. And basically, the idea of virtual mentoring is you can be one-on-one, spend some one-on-one time with one of our consultants, and that's actually included with the training when you make the purchase. So that way, whenever you get through with a training class, or when you get through with, you know, a portion of a class, you have a question about something that was discussed in the class, or if you have a question just about how you can implement it in your environment, so actually on your data, you can use virtual mentoring as a way to back up the material with a live instructor, a live person to talk to you about how to solve your own personal problem. So that's really a great way that we do it, is through that virtual mentoring. It's included with the training, so it's a big, big help.
Great. And also, we have a lot of people that might be new to the SQL Server and BI community.
Yeah.
What are some first steps they can take if they want to start their training?
Yeah, it's a great question. So we have not only some advanced level trainings in our platform, but we also have some intro level courses as well. One of the things that's really helpful to a lot of people is that we have free training. So every week, once a week, we have a free training that we do. And from that, it's a good way of getting you started. It is 1 hour session, so it's not going as in depth as a full course would, but that allows you to be able to get a good overview of a topic and see if it's something that is for you, or do you want to go deeper into it? Maybe a course is worthy of purchasing for that particular topic.
Great. Okay, I know I've asked you some like really important questions that we've had so far, so I have another really in-depth question.
Okay.
Back to the Future, 1, 2, or 3?
2.
Star Wars, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
So I would say episode 5,
awesome.
Empire Strikes Back.
Best one. If you don't think that, then you need to go away. No, I'm just kidding. But if you say 1, 2, or 3, there might be some issues.
You know what? As I grew up, I actually liked Return of the Jedi.
I can see that.
And then I watched them again with my kids now. So I have a 6-year-old and 2 4-year-olds. I have twins. And I watched them again with them, and I realized that I like Empire Strikes more now. So I think maybe as a kid, I liked the conclusion of the story, maybe.
I think so.
Yeah.
Maybe
but,
the Ewoks?
Maybe it might have been the Ewoks. It might have been the little cuddly Ewoks, but now it's definitely Empire Strikes Back is my favorite.
Awesome. Is there anything that we can look forward to in the coming year that we haven't seen in the past from Pragmatic Works in regards to like our consultants? And I know we've talked about some of the new stuff with training, but is there anything else that we might be able to look forward to?
Yeah,
later in the year.
Yeah, I think you're going to see a big emphasis company-wide on advanced analytics. So looking at things like data science, predictive analytics, and how you can take your data that you have and start to make it more actionable and make it so that you're not so reactive to it, and you're actually starting to look at how I can take the past data that I have and make future decisions. that's going to be across the board with our training department, with our consulting services. We have a new advanced analytics part of our consulting services. And even from our software perspective, we have Task Factory has some machine learning capabilities in it for Azure ML for being able to kick off processes there. So you're going to see a big push in that. And this is one of the things I'll tell you guys. If you guys are in BI right now, if you're in business intelligence, this if you're not already looking at advanced analytics and machine learning, that's where your career probably is going to be in the next 7 or 8 years. So start looking at it now. Get that background now, and you'll be a little bit ahead of the game because that's really where BI is going in the future. And the fact that you have that BI background, a lot of what you do in BI is really going to help you towards that advanced analytics section as well.
Great. Now, you've been with Pragmatic Works for several years now. What is some of your favorite memories, or what is your favorite thing about working at Pragmatic Works?
Some of my favorite memories might be also some of the worst memories. I don't know. Let's see. So we have incidents, right, like prank wars that have gone too far. Yeah. Someone's car was attempted to be sold on Craigslist without their knowledge. We had one that I was kind of pranked on, or I wasn't told about at least, where someone got in a fight where there was like fake blood coming down their face, and I'm in the process of calling 911. We're like, no, it's okay. That was always good. Early parts of the company were always fun as well. We were right next to a dog groomer whenever we first started the company, and you could hear dog barking while we're doing demos of products and things like that, and on calls with customers. Yeah. So a lot of those memories are always fun. I love, now we have more folks, obviously, so doing things like chili cook-offs and potlucks and stuff like that's always fun. Those things are great, and I always love doing the end-of-year parties, too. Those are really fun.
Yeah, well, going back to training, this is more coming from people that might be looking into wanting to train other people.
Yeah.
Do you have any tips for, like, first-time trainers or people looking into getting in the training field?
Yeah, so one of the things that I find that is most difficult for people is you almost have to put on a different persona.
Like we're doing right now.
Yeah, like we're doing right now.
No, just kidding.
This is, yeah. No, it's one of the things that people struggle with is it's one thing to know a technology. It's another thing to teach it. And part of the teaching aspect, I know a lot of people that are really smart, but they're just not trainers. It's not their thing. Whether they're not comfortable talking to large groups or they're just not comfortable talking to even small groups, that's a big part of it. And honestly, I started off that way as well. I would say I'm actually a pretty introverted person. I'm very kind of to myself. But when it comes to training, I love doing training. I love teaching others. And I put on a kind of a big personality, almost like a game show host kind of mentality whenever I'm teaching. So being able to fake it, even if it's not you, for that hour or 6 hours, right, or however long the training course is you're doing, it's part of it. It's part of being a trainer.
Yeah. So any final tips or things that we think we need to know about you before we end the segment?
Any tips? If you ever look me in the eye directly, I will hurt you.
Fair warning to all the people that attend our training courses. Well, they'll have that awkward note. Thanks, everybody, for joining us today. And we hope to see you again soon in a future segment.